I'll show you four methods to blur the edges of an image in Photopea. As a preparation, I'll create three copies of the image layer so we can easily compare the results of the four methods at the end of this video. I'll name the layers as Method 1, Method 2, Method 3, and Method 4. I'll also create a white color fill layer as the bottom layer so we can see the results against a white background. Hide the image layers that you are not working on by pressing the eye icon next to the layers. Make sure the correct layer is selected when you start working. The first method is to use the rectangle select tool from the left side menu. By default, the feather value is set to 0. Feather defines how much blur is applied to the selection. I'll use 30 pixels for this example. If you need a fixed ratio or size, use the drop-down menu and text boxes next to it to adjust. With the rectangle select tool active, click and drag with your mouse on the canvas to make a selection. Right now, the area inside the dashed line is selected. But we want to blur the edges, not the inside. Go to Select on the top menu and click Inverse. Now the border area is selected. Next, go to Edit and choose Clear, or press Delete on your keyboard to remove the selection. Click outside your canvas to deselect and see the result of the first method. For the second method, I'll make the Method 2 image layer visible and hide the others. The second method is similar to the first, but uses the Ellipse Select tool instead. From the left side menu, choose the Ellipse Select tool and set the feather value to around 30 pixels. You can set a fixed ratio or size for your ellipse using the drop-down menu, but I'll use the free Ellipse Select for this example. Click and drag with your mouse on the canvas to create the selection. To make a perfect circle instead of an oval, hold Shift while dragging your mouse. Again, we want to blur the edges, not the inside. Go to Select and click Inverse. The dotted line now indicates the border area is selected. Press Delete on your keyboard to blur the edges into a circular shape. Click outside the canvas to deselect and view the result of the second method. The third method lets you create highly customized fades. Make sure the Method 3 layer is visible and hide the others. Start by adding a raster mask to the selected layer. Click Add Raster Mask in the Layers panel. A mask will now be created for the image layer. Ensure the mask is selected, not the image itself. Next, choose the Brush tool from the left side menu. Pick a soft brush, make it large, and set the hardness to 0 for smooth edges. Choose a color to paint on the mask. Remember, darker colors create stronger effects. I recommend starting with black. Before painting, confirm in the Layers panel that the mask is selected. Click and drag on the canvas to start fading the edges. If you make a mistake, you can undo the latest edit by pressing Ctrl-Z or Command-Z on your keyboard. You can switch to white to adjust or reshape the fade. The mask is great because it keeps the original image intact and editable. You can hide the mask by holding Shift and clicking it, then Shift-click again to reveal it. The brush tool method allows for creative, customized fades. For the final method, make the Method 4 layer visible and hide the others. Select the Move tool and ensure the correct layer is active. Right-click the layer and choose Select Pixels. A selection will appear around the entire image. Go to the top menu and click Select, Modify, and then Contract. Enter the width of the border you want in pixels. For this example, I'll set it to 80 pixels. Check Apply at Canvas Bounds and click OK. Next, return to the Select menu, click Modify, and then choose Feather. Set the feather value. I'll use 50 for this example. Leave Apply at Canvas Bounds unchecked and click OK. Now the inside of the dotted line is selected. Go to Select and choose Inverse. The border is now selected. Press Delete on your keyboard to remove the selected border. Finally, go to Select and choose Deselect to clear the selection. Now you can compare the results of all four methods by toggling the visibility of each layer. And that's how you blur the edges of an image in Photopea using four different methods. Like and subscribe for more tutorials. Thanks for watching.